name is K.E. Felix, and I welcome you to K.E. Felix Inspire. Always remember, if you're coming here for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post new videos. Please do stay tuned for more details in this video.
Hey, could we talk about the budget for a moment? Some people are referring to it as a glorified wish list. Others are saying that this is wishful thinking on the part of the current administration. And yet others are calling it a shot in the dark. I heard somebody say the other day that this was just rhetoric, empty rhetoric, that this is a list of things on a paper that we are yet to see the tangibility of. But here's my point. I think it's intentional. It's an intentional budget. And while we agree that the UPND are not a perfect administration, you can travel from here to Timbuktu, from Shangombo to Memphis, Tennessee. You will never ever find a perfect administration, but you will find intent. And in the words of Dr. Nebus Mumba, while we agree that there's no such thing as a perfect government, we do know that there are governments that are better than others. And I can honestly say, without any fear of equivocation or contradiction, that the UPND government is worlds better than the PF. The UPND government is a multiplied multiplicity of multitudinous times better than the PF. And one thing that we must never lose sight of is the fact that these guys have raised the standard of leadership. We know they're not perfect, but in the words of John Maxwell, everything rises and falls with leadership. This administration has intent, and we must applaud that. We do. The opposition are going to do what they do, because that's their job, provide checks and balances. But when it comes to the practicality of this budget, I believe that this administration is out to prove a point. Now, because we were so used to mediocrity for so long, because we lived in an age, a little over 6 years, we lived under the umbrella of an administration that was accidental. Because let's be honest, let's be truthful. President Lungu was not an intentional president. This is the reason that many people throughout his administration would whisper that he had no vision. The reason they said that was because, by his own admission, he didn't have a vision. He was an accidental president. He found himself in a position where greatness was thrust upon him. You know, it's like that passage of scripture in the Word of God that says that the race is not won by the strong and by the quick. Sometimes time and chance happens to them. And President Lungu was the type of president that had time and chance thrust upon him. Now, granted, there are some people, they have the emotional and the intellectual know-how to navigate through life when chance and time has been thrust upon them, or when greatness has been thrust upon them. Unfortunately, our former president didn't have that. If you listen to John Sangwa's sentiments, John Sangwa talking about how President Lungu, what type of person he was, what type of lawyer he was, this is way before he became president. His revelation is quite insightful. You know, John Sangwa says that his impression of President Lungu was a man that was ill-prepared, a man that often came to the table not really knowing what he was supposed to do, a man that was often sort of carried and sort of brought up to date because he was ill-prepared. That is indicative of his character. Now, you take a person like that and you make him president, what happens? Nothing. Okay? So here it is. Because we were used to that type of leadership for so long, and then all of a sudden we have a new type of leadership, a leadership that has intent, it looks strange. It appears off kilter. It appears obscure, because we were so used to mediocrity. We became bottom feeders So much so that when we see someone that was intentional and that has a higher standard, and someone that has raised the bar of leadership, somehow that appears strange. It's like that old quote by Reverend Al Sharpton at Michael Jackson's funeral, when he was addressing that huge crowd at the Staples Center. I think it was the Staples Center in Los Angeles at MJ's funeral. And Michael's kids were sitting on the front row. And Al Sharpton said something very interesting. It may not be apropos for me to quote it here, but I think he meant the same. And the quote was, he said to his kids, Michael's kids, he said, "What, nothing strange about your daddy, but it was strange what your daddy had to go through and what your daddy had to deal with." So my point is, there's nothing strange about being a president. But it was strange that we became so accustomed to mediocrity. And here it is. The reason this president, as flawed as imperfect as he is, he has raised the bar of leadership. Because we're looking at a new brand of leadership, it appears strange. But it shouldn't be strange. It shouldn't be strange. So let's give this administration, I mean, you know, it's amazing to me that people in the beginning, as soon as he was sworn in as president, and I'm not trying to make excuses for him or stand for him or cover for him or anything like that, but as soon as he became president, so many of you, so many of us would jump on this bandwagon of, "No, you promised, we're waiting." Yeah? Remember when Davis Wheeler, the former Secretary General of the Patriotic Front, he says, "No, we're waiting. He promised the dollar to fall." Because, you know, Davis Miller's got this thing where when he's talking, he sort of jitters, you know. "We're waiting. You promised free education. We're waiting." Guys, the man was sworn in on Thursday. I'm just giving you an example. If he was sworn in on a Thursday, that Friday night, you guys want results. It doesn't work that way. Development is a process. It's a process. It's not going to happen overnight. Now, granted, and I have to say this again, this president is not perfect. He's going to make his own mistakes, his own flaws, but he has intent. He's got a deliberate vision for this country. And guys, it's either you get left behind or you jump on the bandwagon. God bless Zambia. Love you. Boom.